sector.
In the past 50 years, fertility has dropped more than 50% worldwide. In some parts of the world, women in their 20s are less fertile than their grandmothers were at age 35. And the average man today has only half the sperm his grandfather had. These are startling statistics put together by Dr. Shanna Swan and a team of researchers.
Dr. Shanna Swan's book is called Countdown: How Our Modern World is Threatening Sperm Counts, Altering Male and Female Reproductive Development, and Imperiling the Future of the Human Race. And she joins us live this morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Happy to be here.
I remember years ago reading an article about how pesticides are impacting sperm counts and so forth and so on. So isn't there somebody who's supposed to be watching out for us, in the FDA or somebody in the government that says, hey, look what's happening. We need to fix this.
Unfortunately not. There's no monitoring of like sperm counts or miscarriages. That's not monitored at all. And as far as monitoring the chemicals that might be related to this, that I believe are related to this, there's no oversight. It's not like drugs where the FDA keeps us safe there. There are chemicals, hundreds, if not thousands of them, in commerce that have never been tested. Hmm. And so we're bearing the brunt of this. You know, with the falling sperm counts and increased miscarriage rates and lower testosterone rates and lower fertility, which we document in our book.
I was looking at some of the chemicals. I mean, some of these things are found in very common things in your household, plastic water bottles, wall-to-wall carpeting, potentially your cookware, even shower curtains. What are, if you're looking for things specifically in your household that you might want to change, where would you start?
I would start in the kitchen, actually, and I would start with getting rid of plastic containers mm-hmm. and anything that food comes in contact with, so food contact materials, anything made of plastic, swap it out for glass or ceramic, and you're going to be making a big first step. And then I would be careful when I shop. I would try to shop as much as possible, buy and eat unprocessed food. That takes time, I know, and eat organic, that takes money, but these are recommendations that can lower your exposure. And then it's important to check the chemicals in the products that you bring into home, like cleaning products and laundry products and skincare products and makeup. They all contain a whole large number of these chemicals that have been shown to impact reproductive health.
But if you're, let's say, 25 years old or 30 years old, and you're thinking of having a baby, you're trying to have a baby, is this a chemical impact over a lifetime of exposure to these things? You're not going to turn it around in a year because you cut out plastic cups or something like that, right? Is that, do I have that?
Yes and no. So there's a good news story and a bad news story. So the good news story is that what we call the non-persistent chemicals, the chemicals
Doctor, hold on a quick second. I'm so sorry. We've got some breaking news that we have to check in. We'll get back to you in a moment. News conference in Boulder on this.